Well, here tonight, it's Libertarian-leaning Republican Congressman from the great state of Kentucky. It's Thomas Massie joining me now. Welcome back, Congressman.
Hey, thank you for having me, Kennedy.
Indeed. This is quite an honor for you. I'm very excited. I'm just kidding.
It is.
Time Magazine's Person of the Year. You are a limited government, Libertarian-leaning Republican. What does Donald Trump have to do, in your mind, to earn that distinction?
You know, at the heart of libertarian principles is a non-aggression policy principle, which means that you don't attack somebody if they don't attack you. So the thing I'm most optimistic about is we're not going to war with Russia, which may have been the case with Hillary. I mean, whether it's in the Ukraine or Syria or even Georgia, Donald Trump has not expressed a willingness to agitate Russia, and I think that's a good move. So I'm optimistic about that. I'm optimistic about some of his cabinet appointments. They're, you know, I wouldn't call any of them libertarian yet, but, you know, on the spectrum of smaller government or bigger government, I personally know some of them, and they're definitely small government type people. And Trump's promised to roll back regulations. And then, you know, when I saw you at the RNC, I'm sure you listened to Trump's riveting speech there. I was there on the floor listening to it. He took a swipe at the World Trade Organization, which yep. sort of warmed my heart. You know, libertarians are for sovereignty and sovereign nations, and we don't think we should subject U.S. citizens to a world government.
No, I mean, I would like to see a few more liberty-minded people considered for some of these positions, as John Allison was, formerly ran the Cato Institute. He was being considered for Treasury Secretary. That obviously did not go his way. And Reason is reporting that you are being considered for two possible posts, including Secretary, Energy Secretary. What do you think about that?
Well, I haven't been contacted about that or the other rumor from the Trump campaign, which is the science policy advisor.
Yeah.
But honestly, Kennedy, if I were, you know, contacted about that, I would consider it seriously. I think they need some common sense in the White House as well as in Congress. So I think I could provide that.
Yeah, I think you could, too. I would love to see a voice like yours in that administration. I know that they are filling some of those posts rapidly. And one of the things that is something we're all going to be watching is the meeting next week with tech titans who have been invited to Trump Tower for a meeting with the president-elect. Now, if you were, in fact, a science and technology policy advisor, what would you tell Donald Trump to ask some of the people from Silicon Valley who were pretty much disinterested in a successful campaign of his?
Well, I don't know what he needs to ask them. I think they're sort of coming hat in hand because none of them were for him. In fact, I think some of them worked on Hillary's campaign. You know, there's more to tech than just Silicon Valley. There's a lot of tech in manufacturing. There's a lot of tech in a bunch of different sectors. And I think the presumption under the previous White House was as long as you had Google people around you, and Google's a fine company, but as long as you had Google people around you, that you were tech. And that's not necessarily true. There's a lot more to technology than just a few companies on the West Coast.
All right, so where do you stand? Should the government force tech companies to comply with some of their orders, particularly when it comes to certain types of speech on social media platforms?
The government shouldn't be forcing anybody to do anything. We're getting back to libertarian principles here. But you know, one issue that's come up in Congress is the subject of intellectual property, and that's debated among libertarians whether there should be patents or not.
Yeah.
And you know, I hold 29 patents, and I'm one of those libertarians that says they're property rights. Patents are property rights, and that's what makes this country better than other countries is we honor property rights. So, you know, you got the companies on the West Coast that aren't keen on patents, and I think that's going to be an interesting thing to see where Donald Trump comes down on that.
All right. Well, we will be keeping an eye on you and, you know, see if you, in fact, do get the nod to go to Trump Tower if you do swing by here in person. Okay, Congressman?
All right. And I want to personally invite you to the inauguration, Kennedy. I've got a ticket with your name on it.
Consider it done. I will absolutely go. I'm going to start dress shopping tomorrow. Not even lying. Congressman
Massie,
thank you
get
so
a warm
much.
One. Okay.